कॉल किसी ने ऑलरेडी क्यों ऑन किया? Okay, so hello and welcome back to an academy. So let's get Neet PG. Myself, Dr. Muskan Chaudhary, your Neet PG mentor for microbiology subject. So today we'll cover the arbovirus, in which we'll study about the dengue mania. So starting with an academy under plus category, we can assess both the live and the recorded sessions and learning from the India's topmost educators for any medical examination, be it NEET, PG or UG examination, compete in the live T&Es and test our preparation with the highly competitive quizzes and the scholarship programs that are being provided by the An Academy, studying on the device of our choice, benefiting from the exclusive chance of watching our classes on the bigger screen, bid up to 25,000 of the MCQs and covering up to 50 to 100 MCQs every day. Coming soon are the printed and digital notes that are also being provided by the An Academy along with the live sessions. Hi Piyush. Okay, and the icon subscriptions, PrepLadder and An Academy has come together. So we get the benefit of both the PrepLadder and the An Academy, where we get the clinical and integrated essentials with video cue banks, video lectures, and the rapid revision snapshots and dream notes with well-structured live badges, recorded sessions, 25,000 MCQs, T&Ds, and the digital notes. Under plus category, for 24 months, it is counting for 36,000 rupees, and that is for 1,500 per month. And for 3 years, it is 1250 and 1625 for 18 months. For icon subscriptions, it is for 2 years, it is 2438. And for 18 months, it is 12875 and 1875 for 36 months. Under NEET PT category, please use my code, that is Muskan 10, not just for NEET PG, for any other medical examination or any of the competitive exam you're going to enroll, you can use my code, that is Muskan 10, to get 10% of the discount. Now, something that is a raise a hand feature that is initiated by the An Academy, new to the platform or any other education platform, where you can raise your hand, ask your doubts, that too in the live sessions from your educator, clear your basics and help yourself in getting your concepts clear. So special class features includes the interactive live sessions, attending the live class, participating in the live chat, doing the polling for the learners, respond to the polls for a better understanding of the topic, raise a hand, talk to educator in the live sessions and get your doubts cleared. Never miss a class because you will get the notification for the same, upcoming courses and recommendations created just for you. Lecture notes, that you can download the lecture notes and you will also get the PDFs and the printed digital notes along with that. And you can watch the sessions anytime and anywhere, specifically for those students who are having a hectic schedule of the internship or the doing the JR, so that is difficult for them. Okay, so we'll start with the arbovirus, and in the arbovirus first we'll start with a few of the most important arbovirus family virus that are specifically questions are being asked. Now we have one is the single stranded positive sense RNA. We have the family Togaviridae and the this Flaviviridae family. In the single stranded but negative sense RNA, we have discussed in brief a little that positive sense RNA and the negative sense RNA. Then we have the double stranded RNA, that is the one exceptions that is very important, is the Rioviridae. Please remember this, Rioviridae is what? A double stranded RNA. Like this, we remember that DNAs are double stranded RNA, double stranded DNA virus, but we have the single stranded DNA virus. The exception was the parvovirus. That was the exception, parvovirus. Similarly, RNA, that is a single stranded mostly, but there we have the double stranded RNA, and we have to remember this exception as well, that is the reovirus. Alright, then we have the single stranded negative sense, that is the Bunia viridae and the Reptoviridae as well as Orthomyxo. So, starting with the arbovirus, now which of the arbovirus that is commonly found in India, some of the important arbovirus and the vector that plays a major role in causing the disease, so we'll come to each of them. So, first that is the arbovirus that are common in India causing the hemorrhagic fever, they are what? The dengue, chikungunya and KFD, that is the Kyanisel forest disease. Then we have the encephalitis, that is Japanese encephalitis, West Nile fever and the Sinbis. Rare are the Crimean Congo hemorrhagic fever, Ganjman Willow, Chandipur or Banja or Umbra, the Chittor. So that is, and next is the yellow fever, but that is not found in India. So please remember that one is the yellow fever, which is not found in India. Now, moving next. Now, first is the dengue fever and the yellow fever and the chikungunya. What we need to remember is we need to remember the vector for them. The vector for them is the tiger mosquito. What is the tiger mosquito? That is, we are talking about the Aedes. Okay, so as you can see, the white patches. That is a name after that, the white patches. You can easily see the white spots like present on the mosquito, and that is known as the tiger mosquito or the Aedes, that is responsible as the vector for the dengue, yellow fever and chikungunya. Now, moving next, that is the Japanese encephalitis, for the vector is what? Culex. Now it is what? Again a vector borne, that is the Culex mosquito, a rural mosquito that breeds where? In the rice fields, and it is the principal vector for causing the Japanese encephalitis. In 1955, the virus was isolated from the Culex vishnui, because Culex vishnui is found in India, and in the world we get the Culex triitenon. So it was actually isolated from the Culex vishnui, that is found mainly in the South Indian regions of the India. So remember the vectors, one is having the Aedes for the yellow fever, chikungunya and the dengue. Next we are having the Culex for the Japanese encephalitis. So talking about the Culex mosquito. So it is a gray with white, silver, green or the blue scales, and it is yellow shape, narrow yellow shape, and mostly found throughout the US, and this half, this 1/4 inch in size. Next vector we are having is the tick, that is a hard tick that is causing what? The KFD, that is a Kyanisel forest disease, and if you remember the pick is the amplifying host for the Kyanisel forest disease. Virus has been isolated from the 16 species of the ticks, but hard tick of the genus, that is the Haemophysalis particularly, are the main vectors. So remember the vectors, that first we talked about the Aedes for the dengue, yellow fever and chikungunya, and for the Japanese it is Culex, and then we have the ticks for the KFD. Next is we are having the sandfly. That is responsible for the sandfly fever or the and the Rift Valley fever. How to recognize now this mosquito? That is by wings. You can see the sandfly wings, they are covered by the hair covering the wings and the body, with the long antenna and the short proboscis. So mainly you can easily recognize by the hair on the wings and the body. Next, we are having the anopheles, that is causing which arbovirus infection? That is the Nyong virus. The males have the bushy antenna. You can see the males have the bushy antenna and the long palps, while the females generally have the short palps and the lightly feathered antenna. So how to differentiate male and the female is that the males have the bushy antenna and the females doesn't have so. Why I'm telling the tips to recognize the mosquito, the reason is being that the mosquito images are being given and the disease they cause, the vector they act in the disease is directly asked. So that is, this is what the anopheles is. We talked about the difference between the males and the females. That is the bushy antenna present in case of the males and not so in case of the females. Then we have the rodent borne arbovirus infection that is causing what the Hanta virus. That is the Hanta seol and the pumila and the prospect hill virus. Coming to the animal reservoir from the arbovirus family. Now, in many cases, the actual reservoir is not known, but birds are acting as the reservoir. Also, we also read the individual reservoir in each of the disease, each of the viral infection, but we also see, check out the, in short, before the reservoirs that are present. In the Japanese encephalitis, the birds are in the Japanese encephalitis, St. Louis encephalitis. Pigs, they are also in the Japanese encephalitis and the pigs are very important. They are the amplifying host in the case of the Japanese encephalitis. Again, important one, that is the yellow fever. Yellow fever, although not found in India, but the monkeys are the animal reservoir. Then we have the rodents, that is the Russian spring and the summer encephalitis. Clinical features of the different groups of the arbovirus, that is the fever and the rash with the arthralgia, but it is not that specific. Then we have the encephalitis presenting, and then we have the hemorrhagic fever. We know already that hemorrhagic fever is present in the dengue, in the yellow fever and the chikungunya. Other than this, the Hanta fever and the Crimean Congo hemorrhagic fever. Then we have the hemorrhagic fever with the shock that we study in the dengue. Lab, coming to the lab diagnosis of the arbovirus. Now we go for the agglutination test, that is for the antibody. Now other than this, we go for the CFT complement fixation, neutralizing antibody ELISA, and the indicators we go for the IgM detection and the IgG seroconversion, and we see for the fourfold rise in the IgG. Isolating suckling mice brain. Culture in the mosquito cell lines and detection of the antigen, that is the NS1 antigen, and detection of the RNA by the RT-PCR technique. Now coming to each of the individual arbovirus, so we'll come first to the very important one, that is the Japanese encephalitis. Now, Japanese encephalitis, from the name itself, first was seen where in the Japan, and it is known as the summer encephalitis, but now found in the whole world, so that is not specific to Japan only. So Japanese encephalitis first found in the Japan, known as the summer encephalitis, called B to distinguish from the encephalitis A. And encephalitis lethargica, that is, and we are talking about the two types of Japanese encephalitis. We are having B and the A. Now it has spread from the Korea to India to Malaysia. And vector, we have already seen, the vector is the Culex mosquito. All right, in India, which one is common? In India, Culex, from the name itself, that the Culex vishnui. And in the world, it is a Culex tritanniorhynchus. Remember that Japanese encephalitis, known as the summer encephalitis, first seen in the Japan, now common in the world, and the vector is the Culex mosquito, that is the Culex vishnui in the India, and the Culex tritanniorhynchus in case of the world. In India, epidemics was seen in the 14 states. UP accounts for the largest burden of the Japanese encephalitis, and that to the Gorakhpur district. shows the iceberg phenomena. I hope you remember the iceberg phenomena, that the more cases are present in the community than they are subclinically present than they are appearing in the community. Subclinical cases ratio is about case is to subclinical ratio is about 1 to 300. That means the subclinical cases are way larger than the clinical cases. So very important that they show what the iceberg phenomena. Incubation period is up to 15 days and 85% of the cases occurs in children that is below 15 years. Cases fatality rate is high, that is up to 40%. So that was Japanese encephalitis starting from the Japan and seen by the vector Culex and shows the iceberg phenomena and fatality up to 40% and incubation period up to 15 days. Now coming to very important, that is the source. Now, what are the sources? That are the birds, and that is the cattle, egrets, and the ducks. Amplifying host is very important to remember. They are the pigs and the bats, because this is the question that is repetitively asked, that what are the amplifying host in the Japanese encephalitis, and very important that are pigs and the bats, and birds are the reservoirs. Mosquito attractant, that is the cattle and the buffalo infected, but they are not the natural host for the Japanese encephalitis. Incidental hosts are the horse and only animals to be symptomatic. Human either is the dead end host. So human is not a host for the Japanese encephalitis. Human is a dead end host because it will not be able to complete its life cycle in case of the human. Japanese encephalitis is the most common cause of the epidemic encephalitis, and since we know that the name itself first was the summer encephalitis, that it shows the seasonal variation in the temperate areas, that is in the summer to autumn, and the tropical, and like in India found where, that is the June to October. Prophylaxis, we give the live attenuated cell derived vaccine. So what are the important points to remember here that the questions are asked? Now first are the reservoir, that are the birds, and the amplifying host, that is very important, are the pigs and the bats. Mosquito attractants are there, buffaloes and all, but a human is a dead end host and shows a seasonal variation and most common cause for the epidemic encephalitis. Very important, the strain that we use for the live attenuated vaccine, the strain that we use for the attenuated live vaccine is what? Nakayama strain. Okay, that is the Nakayama strain. That is what? That is the mouse brain derived vaccine. Mouse brain derived vaccine. That is what? The Nakayama strain. Inactivated vaccine, Beijing strain, mouse brain derived, and the Beijing P3 strain cell line life derived. So now moving next, that is the mosquito, that is the Culex mosquito, bites the birds and picks up the JE virus. Infected mosquito bites an animal, passes on the virus. Virus multiplies inside the body, that is the amplifying host are the pigs and the bats. Mosquito bites infected animals and picks up the virus, and this is how the cell, this is how the life cycle of the JE continues. Infected mosquito when bite the deadened host, that is the human, then who are unable to pass the mosquitoes. That is the humans are the dead end host for the Japanese encephalitis. So we are done with it. That is the important points. Known as the summer encephalitis, shows the seasonal variation and shows the iceberg phenomena with high fatality rate up to 40%. Those are the birds with amplifying host as the pigs and the bats. Humans are the dead end host, and the prophylaxis we give the live vaccination. And the strain that we use inactivated vaccine is the Nakayama strain. Alright, so now moving to the next very important one, that is we'll talk about the dengue. So that is, we will talk about the dengue. Now dengue has the four serotypes, that is 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 5th even has been recognized in 2013. Most common arbovirus India, that is what we are having abundant of the dengue. And as we know, we just now had so many dengue cases a month ago. Vector we saw already saw for the dengue, for the yellow fever, and the, for the chikungunya we had the Aedes as the vector, that is the tiger mosquito, that is the Aedes tiger mosquito. Most common Aedes agapti, but also by the Aedes albopictus or other Aedes. Aedes becomes infective by feeding the patient from a day before the onset of the onset to fifth day of the illness when the viremia is there. So dengue has the four serotypes, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and the fifth one is also there, with the most common arbovirus that is present in India. And Aedes is the vector that is responsible and becomes infective after feeding a day before to the onset to the fifth day of the illness. Extrinsic incubation period is 8 to 10 days. Aedes, once infected, remains infective for the whole life. And the transovarian transmission is seen in case of the Aedes. Men and the Aedes itself is the reservoir. Mixed infection is more common, and it is due to the antibody dependent enhancement. What is that? We'll read about it. So we see a mixed type of infection in case of the dengue. Clinical features are very important. One is the dengue fever, where we see the biphasic saddleback type of fever. We see the saddleback fever, that is defined as the fever, the patients with the reoccurrence of the fever lasting less than 24 hours after defervescence beyond day 7 of the illness. So that is the saddleback fever with the break bone type of fever and the lymphadenopathy. Then we have the dengue hemorrhagic fever, that is an acute high grade type of fever that is continuous for 2 to 7 days, and with positive tourniquet test, that is the petechial spots more than 20 per square inch in the cubital fossa are seen, with the enlargement of the liver and the low count, that is thrombocytopenia, and the heme concentration, that is hematocrit, raised by the 20%, more than 20%. So that is that about dengue, having the five serotypes now, and the most common arbovirus in India, and transovarian transmission. Reservoir is a man and the Aedes with the mixed infection. It is due to antibody dependent enhancement. We see the dengue fever and the dengue hemorrhagic fever. Dengue fever is type of a saddleback fever with the break bone type of the fever, with the dengue hemorrhagic fever, that is very high grade of fever for continuous 2 to 7 days with the positive tourniquet test, enlargement of the liver, a low count of the platelets, thrombocytopenia, and the heme concentration more than 20% of the hematocrit is raised. Now, what is ADE? That is antibody dependent enhancement of the infection occurs when pre-existing antibody present in the body from a first dengue vial, because it is having then 1, 2, 3, and 4 type of serotypes. Like first, the person has the had the infection with the 10 one, so he will form the antibodies against the 10 one, and due bind to the infected 10 particles present during a subsequent infection with a different dengue serotype. Now, what will happen? Antibodies that are formed against the DEN1 in the first infection, it used to neutralize the DEN1 serotypes because that was particular for the DEN1. Now, suppose the same patient is having the infection with the DEN2, but since the antibodies formed against the DEN1 will also act against again DEN2, but they are not neutralizing in this case. They will attach with the DEN2 virus, because but they will not neutralize it. So this will cause the enhancement of the infection instead of neutralizing of the infection. So this is what occurs when the pre-existing antibodies present in the body from a primary dengue virus infection bind to an infective DEN particle during a subsequent infection with a different dengue serotype. The antibodies from the primary infection cannot neutralize the virus. Instead, the AB virus complex attached to receptors on circulating monocytes. These antibodies helps the virus infect the monocytes more efficiently. The outcome is the increase in the overall replication of the virus and higher risk of the severe dengue So that is what, once the antibodies formed against any serotype, if next time the serotype infection is different, then these antibodies, instead of neutralizing these virus, will attach to these virus, and this complex will be taken up by the macrophage, and instead they will replicate inside the macrophage and they will not be destroyed. So this will lead into the oral replication of the dengue virus instead of neutralizing it, and a higher risk of the severe dengue fever. So you see, this is a DEN, and this is a heterotypic antibody from the previous infection. So this is the complex that is the form, that is the DEN with the antibody. So this will attach to the monocyte, and inside the monocyte they will continuously replicate and release their daughter virions. So instead of monocyte neutralizing them and killing them, they will help in the replication of the virus and resulting in the enhancement of a disease to a greater load. Now, moving next is the dengue shock syndrome. Now, what is the dengue shock syndrome? All the above criteria of the dengue hemorrhagic fever, that is a continuous high grade fever for 2 to 7 days with positive tourniquet test with increased hematocrit and lower thrombocytopenia, that is less than 1 lakh, they all will be included in the dengue hemorrhagic fever with additional symptoms, that is the shock manifestation with the rapid and the weak pulse with the narrow pulse pressure that is less than 20 mm of Hg, or the hypotension with the presence of the cold, clammy skin and the restlessness. So all the features of the dengue hemorrhagic fever with the features of the shock or the hypotension, when they are also included with the dengue hemorrhagic fever, leads to the dengue shock syndrome. Now, what are the factors that determine the outcome? What are the factors that determine the outcome of the dengue? So that is the presence of the neutralizing antibody. Very, very important, because the more the non-neutralizing antibodies are present, the greater will be enhancement of the viral replication. Other than this, the less than 12 years of age, they are more prone for the infection. Females, that is, one is the 12 years of age less than, then we have the females more than males that are affected. Whites are more effective than that of the blacks, and the malnourished people than that of the nutritionally well-established people. Sequence of infections, generally serotype 1 followed by 2, seem to be more dangerous, and it is due to the ADE, that is antibody dependent enhancement of the viral load. Infective serotype type 2 is apparently more dangerous, and temperature of 37 degrees Celsius. So what are the factors that determine the outcome? Presence of the enhancing non-neutralizing antibody, then depending upon the age, sex, race and the nutrition status and the serotype, that is, although serotype 2 is more dangerous than the 2, but if the serotype 1 followed by the 2 will be more dangerous, that is due to the ADE. Then we have the vaccine. Then we have recently developed vaccine for the, remember, just remember the vaccine name, that is a dengue vaccine, and it is given between 9 to 15 years of age. The successful vaccination for the dengue virus was not established for the same reason, to different serotypes of the dengue virus. The vaccination, we had the problem with the vaccination. We now have the dengue vaccine, that is the 9 to 15 years it is given. Parenteral route and given by the subcutaneous route. Okay, so we'll just revise and do the question answers for the dengue and the arbovirus. So that was it. It was a small class. So dengue has a 4 serotypes, 1, 2, 3, 4. Most common arbovirus India with the transovirin transmission. We have the dengue fever, the saddleback fever, brave bone fever, and the dengue hemorrhagic fever with the fever acute high and the continuous for the 2 to 7 days. The positive tourniquet test and the enlargement of the liver. Thrombocytopenia less than 1 lakh and the heme concentration more than 20%. ADE, we discussed about it. How does it work? And dengue shock syndrome, DHF, along with the shock and the hypotension. factors determining that is the non-neutralizing antibodies less than 12 years, females are more prone with the white race more than that of the black one, and the ADE as serotype 2 that is more dangerous. We have the dengue vaccine. Now we'll come to the first question. Okay, now move to the first question. Which of the following is the true arbovirus, that is the HSV, JE, ECO or the hantavirus? Yes, so which of the following is a true virus?